As of 2023, Gulu City has been praised as one of the most vibrant, fastest growing, and cleanest cities in Uganda. The city's expansive modern road infrastructure has equally received national attention from both visitors and residents.
Thank the government of Uganda for taking the initiative to make the city more beautiful, and that is in the area of roads. Yes, our road network is a good one, especially within the city center.
So our roads are good. They have their sizes in terms of width is good.
But behind all this beautiful face is the toil and energy of the external labor force. Contractors are allegedly forced to recruit from afar due to a lack of skills and qualifications.
So our drivers, they have lower classes of driving, and they need also to go and do a special training on how to operate the machine. Even in the city here, we advertise the position of machine operators. Almost four of them, we fail to get them. And the driver who are now here in the city is the one that we are training them on jobs so that they can operate this machine.
Gulu City requires contractors to employ a minimum of 30% local people in their construction projects. Moses Okot, an instructor at Tio Plant Outsourcing and Logistics, believes that the gap is being created by a lack of training institutions to skill the local labor force in manning and driving road construction equipment.
So, at the first step, the engineers who always in practical work, you get more experience to overcome the challenges when you go for road construction engineering. So an engineer who come from school and sit at home may not become experts in roads.
In the past 5 years, there have been several road construction projects in Gulu City implemented by USMID and the China Railway Group 18. And the allegations that there are no people qualified to drive and operate this road construction equipment does not sit well with the residents and the local leaders.
I speak this with evidence. You can go and check in the offices of China Railway. You can go and check in the offices of Zhongmei construction companies. Very few local people are being what? Are being employed. So it's not true that we have a skills gap. Our people are skilled. We can offer both skilled and unskilled what? Unskilled labor.
These projects are seen by the residents of Gulu City as an opportunity to employ the redundant youth.
I would say that someone who has carried water in a bucket knows the pain of losing a drop. When the locals are involved in developing their area, they will always have the love to defend it and protect it.
But not all hope has been lost. Titus Mulari Odiwor is the director of Tio Plant Outsourcing and Logistics, a heavy machine training center in Gulu. He believes that bringing training services closer to the people will help close the current gap.
Operators are on high demand. Currently, we are just hiring the operators from Nairobi. Now, there is a need that we should train our own. Then we employ our own instead of our youths and other people luxurying outside. And yet, there is an opportunity here.
The Gulu City Mayor Alfred Okwonga and his leadership are now calling on all the prospective drivers to upgrade their qualifications.
To the drivers, not to wait for the work, then you go and start training. They should invest in their skills. They should go for further training, and also they should upgrade the class of their permit so that when jobs is there, they come and just fit. Because if you have a lower class, people advertise for a higher class, it will be very difficult for you to.
The city has also embarked on linking all regional district planners to forge a way forward of equipping the locals with the necessary skills required as Gulu opens up more opportunities as it gains momentum as a leading metropolis. I'm Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.